Since I know about triangular numbers and I know how to sum constants, I can combine those two facts to sum more complicated expressions. For example, let's do the sum as n goes from 1 to k of 2n minus 1. Right, and what this notation means is that I plug in the numbers from 1 to k into this expression and add them up. So plug in n equals 1, I get 1. Plug in n equals 2, I get 3. Plug in n equals 3, I get 5. Plug in n equals 4, I get 7. All right, and I'm going to keep on going until I end with 2k minus 1. In words, right, what is this asking me to do? Well, 1, 3, 5, this is adding up odd numbers, right? So I could say in words that this is the sum of the first k odd numbers. Right, I'm going to add up the first k odd numbers, 1 plus 3 plus 5, until I get to the kth odd number, which is 2k minus 1. Let's first work this out algebraically. So algebraically, I've got the sum of 2m minus 1 as n goes from 1 to k. And this is summing this difference, so I could write this as the difference of two sums. So both of these are sums as n goes from 1 to k. But now I'm adding up 2n, and I'm just adding up 1. Now I can pull out this factor of 2 by distributivity. So this is 2 times the sum of n as n goes from 1 to k minus just the sum of 1 n goes from 1 to k. I'm going to have a formula for the sum of just the first k whole numbers, right? And if you remember back to that formula, that's k plus 1 times k over 2. And what's just the sum of 1 as n goes from 1 to k? Well, this is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 k times, so that's just minus k. Now this is 2 times something divided by 2, so this is k plus 1 times k, and then minus k. Well, if I expand this out, I've got k plus 1 times k minus 1 times k. This is k squared. So the sum of the first k odd numbers is k squared. But I can also see this fact that the sum of odd numbers gives me perfect squares. I can see this fact geometrically. So I'll draw, say, one dot, and then I'll draw three more dots. Right, this is 1 plus 3, it's 2 squared. Then I'll draw 5 more dots. 1 plus 3 plus 5, that's 3 squared. Then I'll draw 7 more dots. All right, and that's 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, that's 4 squared. And then I'll draw 9 dots, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that's 5 squared, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 is 5 squared, 25. And I'll add 11 dots, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11, right, the sum of the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 odd numbers is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 squared. It's 36. So the upshot here is that if you sum odd numbers, you end up getting perfect squares. And I think that's cool independent of everything else, right? That you can see that fact geometrically. But the real takeaway here is to remember that you can actually do summation problems, right? If somebody gives you a complicated sum, by using facts like the sum of just n and the sum of constants, you can combine those facts to evaluate more complicated summation problems.